children, welcome to biology class. We are discussing the lesson microbes in human welfare. Two more topics are the microbes as biocontrol agents and microbes as biofertilizers. Okay, so today we will conclude this lesson. It's very simple, it was very small lesson, right? But in the question paper we can see questions based on examples. So especially in today's topic, while I am explaining the examples, you should listen it carefully and study it carefully. Don't forget to study all the examples. Okay, so we can start learning. So first topic, microbes as biocontrol agents. So we know that different methods are there to remove different types of pests and disease causing organisms, isn't it? So nowadays different farmers are using different types of chemicals. We know that it kills our earth, it will kills our soil. So, how can we get rid of this? An important way to get rid of this is use of biocontrol agents. Okay, so let's start learning. You know that biocontrol refers to the use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests. Okay, so what are the methods in agriculture? There is a method of controlling pests that relies on natural predation rather than introduced chemicals. We know that while we introduce these chemicals, it causes different types of pollutions. It will kill our soil, it will kill our water, even air, and it kills human being itself. It causes different types of damages to all the living organisms in the world, isn't it? So, the organic farmer creates a system where pests are not eradicated but kept at manageable levels. Very important. Kept at manageable level by complex system of check and balance within the living and vibrant ecosystem. Clear? So, we can start from first example. First example, the ladybird and dragonflies are used to get rid of aphids and mosquitoes respectively. So, this is here. We can see the diagram of ladybird beetle or ladybug and its larva. Larva eating aphids. Okay. So, predatory. It is predatory during all life stages. Not only in the adult stage, in all life stages, it shows its predatory mechanism, predatory behavior. Okay. Adults also feed on pollen and nectar. Individuals may consume as many as 5,000 aphids in their lifetime. Okay. Over winter, under vegetation or bark, that is its habitat. Clear, children? Next example, dragonfly, same as that of ladybird, we can use dragonfly as a biocontrol agent. Then, third example, Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a bacteria, on brassicas and fruit trees to control butterfly caterpillars, bacteria, Bacillus thuringiensis is used. I know you are familiar with the term BT cotton. Isn't it? BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis. So, by using biotechnological principles, we can incorporate this Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria into the cells of any plant. Example, the case of cotton plant, we can add this Bacillus thuringiensis into the cells of the plant. And you just imagine if an organism or a pest which feeds on the leaves or any part of this plant, you know what happened? This Bacillus thuringiensis is having a particular gene termed as cry gene, CRY, cry gene. It produces a protoxin, but it is an inactive stage always. But once it enters to the gut of the pest or the caterpillar, you know what happened? Some enzymes will release or some alkaline medium is there in the gut of the caterpillar. It activates the inactive protoxin and it releases the toxic substance and kills the pest. Clear? I will show you some diagrams. You know what happened? The crop is infected by European corn borer. If Bacillus thuringiensis is added, what happened? BT gene is inserted into the crop and pest dies when feeding on any plant part. Okay? Another same process, Nanda explains through another diagram. Crystals and spores are ingested by insect larvae. So toxins are activated to active form by gut enzymes and activated toxin binds to receptor, subsequently inserts into the membrane and causes leakage of ions and small molecules and causes the death of the pest or insects. Clear? Next example. Biological control developed for use in the treatment of plant disease as the fungus Trichoderma. Okay, Trichoderma are free living fungi that are very common in the root system that control several plant pathogens. Okay, and here you can see two photographs. In first photographs, it tells about the attachment to the host hypha by coiling and can penetrate the host cell walls by secreting different types of lytic enzymes. Lysis means cleavage. It includes chitinases, proteases and cellulase to cleave chitin, protein and cellulose respectively. Clear? It is available in bottle form. We can use it. We can mix it with soil and we can add in our farm or field. Then another example, baculoviruses. They are pathogens that attack insects and other arthropods. But the majority of baculoviruses used as biological control agents and which are included in the genus Nucleopolyhedrovirus. Clear? These viruses are excellent candidates for species-specific narrow-spectrum insecticidal applications. We can explain it with the help of this diagram. Just listen, the baculovirus is sprayed on the leaf and what happens? The caterpillar consumes the baculovirus. You know what happens? The protein encapsulating the baculovirus DNA dissolves and the DNA enters the stomach cell of the caterpillar. Here, the baculovirus DNA is replicated by stomach cells until the stomach cell ruptures. So, the caterpillar stops feeding and the baculovirus DNA is spread throughout the caterpillar causing a general systemic infection and the caterpillar will die within days. Clear? And this table tells us about the major type of bioagents available for commercial production in India. So, three categories are the parasitoids, predators, insects, pathogens, Trichoderma, different species of Trichoderma are included in the category of parasitoids. Then Cryptolemus and Chrysopa species included as predators. Then insect pathogen include nuclear polyhedrovirus, just now we explained. Then Bacillus thuringiensis, in short BT. Then fungi and some nematodes. Clear, children? So, we can use different types of organisms for the purpose of biocontrol. Okay, we can use different types of organism as biocontrol agent. It will serve our soil. It will save our water bodies. It will save the living organism. Clear? Another topic is microorganisms as biofertilizers. We know that fertilizers used to increase the quality of the soil, to increase the fertility of the soil. So if we use chemical fertilizers only aiming large yield, what happens? It will kill the soil. No further fertility or productivity will not be there in the same field, isn't it? But we have to use biofertilizers. It will enrich the soil. It will add different types of minerals, micronutrients, macronutrients, etc. And it enrich the soil fertility. Okay. Biofertilizers are organisms that enrich the nutrient quality of soils. So we can use different types of organisms. The main sources include bacteria, fungi, and cyanobacteria. This diagram is very familiar to you, isn't it? What is this? Presence of rhizobium bacteria in the root nodules of leguminous plants, isn't it? So we had studied the process and plus one. So the root nodule formed by rhizobium bacteria on root of leguminous plants increase the nitrogen level of soil necessary for various metabolic processes. We know it, isn't it? No need of further explanation. It is available in packets too. We can mix it with soil and we can spread on our field. Another example, Acetobacter and Azospirillum are free living bacteria that live in soil and fix atmospheric nitrogen into organic forms. So bacteria supply nitrogen to plant and plant supplies carbon to bacteria and they survive in the nodules of leguminous plants. Third example, symbiotic association of fungi with angiosperm plants. We can call it as mycorrhiza. It also increases the fertility of soil. So, we know that glomules forms mycorrhiza that absorbs phosphorus from the soil and passes it to the plant. So these microbes also provide benefits like resistance to root borne pathogens, tolerance to salinity and drought. Symbiosis, symbiotic relationships are there. So in this photograph we can see two plant species with or without mycorrhiza. Okay, so symbiotic relationships are there between the plant and fungi. So mycorrhizae are symbiotic relationship with plants. Fungus transfer minerals to plant's root and root supply carbohydrates to fungus. Clear? And the fourth example, cyanobacteria, nostoc, anabinia, and they are autotrophic microbes. Autotrophs means they can synthesize their own food. Found in aquatic and terrestrial environment, fix atmospheric nitrogen. So in paddy fields, this acts as important biofertilizer. Blue-green algae also add organic matter to the soil and increase its fertility. Okay, clear? So from oil mill wastewater, we can culture the cyanobacteria and can add it into our fields. Clear, children? So that's about today's class. Very small topics we discussed, but you can expect question for examination. Okay, so while you're studying these two topics, don't forget to study each and every examples. Clear? And nitrogen fixation by cyanobacteria, same. Single cell organisms living on surface of water or plants in a submerged environment produce their own food through photosynthesis of a native to the paddy field. Clear? So we completed three lessons, right? So these three lessons included in the unit Biology for Human Welfare. In that unit, three chapters were the first one was human health and diseases, then strategies for enhancement in food production, and the last one, microbes in human welfare, isn't it? So keep it in mind, don't forget to read the textbook, okay? Read each and every line of textbook and study the notes. Tomorrow we can meet in live session, so you can expect questions. So study well, read. Okay, you are spending only 3 hours per day, isn't it? So use this corona time effectively and efficiently. Okay, so we can meet tomorrow. Okay, thank you.